Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making pounded round steak with onion mushroom gravy. And I think you'll like it because I've done round steak before. This has a little bit different twist on it. And we're going to start by looking at the round steak. This was 1.89 pounds. So that means with six of them, they're about 1/3 pound each. And for Rick and me, that's quite a bit of meat for one serving. So I decided, since these are going to be pounded, as I mentioned in the title, that I would cut them in halves first. So I'll just go down the middle and make a slice. And that looks pretty small, but when you pound it, I'm going to put some protective plastic wrap, a couple of sheets over the top. When you pound it, you might have something like this. You can use either side that you want and see what kind of results you're getting, and then maybe change. It will flatten out, so we want to conserve the space in our skillet, so we don't want to start with the huge one and flatten it out to this size. It would take us several layers or several times of actually frying the meat. Okay, so we're going to just pound on this. And I'm not finished, but I want you to see that there is some effect on this. It is flattening out a little bit, and this will do the tenderizing. So we'll just be salting these and putting some pepper on them, but they will be tenderized from the pounding. You can see how the round steak turned out after it was pounded, and these are nice serving sizes for Rick and me. You may prefer to leave them larger, but it's just a matter of preference, and they are certainly going to be tender because they've been pounded thoroughly. And I'm in the process of salting. I salted the bottom side, flipped it over, and now this is the last one. I need to salt the top side. You'll notice I have a bag here that has flour in it. I put 1.5 cups of self-rising flour. It doesn't really have to be self-rising. That was just what I had handy. But it's 1.5 cups, and you really won't need that much, but I plan to use this to make the gravy. So whatever's left in here, I'll use what I need for the gravy. So I'm going to use my tongs and put a few in at a time, say these four right here. And what I have going on the stove is a large cast iron skillet that has 1 cup of peanut oil. And that's getting hot, hopefully. So we're going to take just about 4 of those over there at a time. And I like to have a single layer. That probably won't work out, but I'll be able to, I think I'll just use my hands instead of trying to keep them clean. It's been about 2 minutes since I saw you last, and I can see that the oil here is kind of shimmering, and that tells me that it's probably going to sizzle a little bit when I put the flour in. That's good enough, and you'll probably hear a sizzle when I put a piece of the round steak in, and I want to kind of shake it off a little bit, hopefully back into the bag, and then place that in the oil. And we'll just go ahead with the other 3 I have in this bag, and we'll try to put them in a layer, trying not to overlap unless it's necessary, and it probably will be necessary toward the end. So I'll take care of this, and that means I need to go back and get the other 8 pieces. I started out with 6 pieces and then divided them into 2, so I have 12 pieces all together. And here are my first 4. They're going to be fried at medium heat. I need to bring that down just a little bit. And then I'm going to put the others in, and we'll work on that. You can see I have all 12 of the round steak pieces in this big skillet. It wouldn't go on a single layer, but that's all right. What we're going to do is to shallow fry them. And I've just gotten the rest of the pepper browned over the top so that each of them got pepper. I did the first layer before I did the second layer. When you shallow fry something like a steak, you want to keep checking the bottom. And when it is brown on the bottom and it seems to be done half the way through,
That's when you turn it over and brown the other side and get it done half the way through. Now, in the meantime, while that cooks, I have some butter in a little skillet here, and I'm going to do the beginning of our gravy. I decided that I wanted it to be onion and mushroom flavored. So this is one onion. It turned out to be about 1 1/2 cups. And I decided to use an equal amount of mushrooms. So I have 1 1/2 cups of mushrooms, fresh mushrooms chopped. Now those came from being bought in this form. They were sliced, but I wanted them a little bit finer for gravy, so I just chopped them up about the same size as the onion. So all of this goes into 3 tablespoons of melted butter, which I have begun to heat. It's probably not sizzling yet, but due to time constraints, I'm going to go ahead and put it in there and then just start stirring this around. And we'll keep working on this as our meat progresses. And what we'll have are some softened onions and mushrooms to go in our gravy. I'm just finishing up taking out the pieces of round steak. And the last 3 pieces that are coming out are the last 3 that went in. And you'll notice that everything is sizzling quite a lot. I did turn the heat up a little bit higher just recently because I wanted all of the remaining crust and fond that might be in the skillet. I wanted it browned up. And I wanted to maintain as much of the crispiness and the brownness as possible on the meat, but it goes on a plate or a platter on paper toweling in order to drain, and then it gets tinted with aluminum foil. So it doesn't have to be crimped really tight around here. We just want to keep it warm a little bit while we make our gravy. Now here's what's left in the skillet after pouring all of the grease off. The grease is right here, and you know we started with 1 cup of peanut oil, so most of that was still there, and then there might have been some fat that cooked out of the round steak. I didn't want to use any of that in the gravy, so I've got something that's completely dry except for the little bits of fat that might be in this fond. So what I want to do is to add in more fat. I prefer to have a butter-based roux, so we're going to start by heating this. And we'll get this melted, and we will add in flour. And we'll just use flour that we used as we coated our round steak pieces. So I guess I'll have to work on this a little bit. It's going to take some time, but I will try to show you the pertinent points as we go along, and eventually I will be serving our pounded round steak with onion mushroom gravy to you. Now what I've added to what was left in the pan is 2 tablespoons of butter, and then I put 4 tablespoons of flour. And I have let this cook for about 5 minutes, so it's nice and brown. The flour is done, you don't have to worry about that, so you may add your liquid. And I'm going to add water. I like to keep that nice brown look, but if you want to add milk, that's fine. It will give you a creamy look. I have I've put in 1 cup, and we will just be stirring and seeing what the consistency is. And I probably need to turn this down a little bit so it doesn't get away from me. We'll need some more. I want to put another cup. This is a 2-cup measure that I had sitting here, and I've got some more if I need it. But right now, this is really cooled down, so it's going to take some time to come back up to heat, and then we can see the consistency of our gravy. Well, this is beginning to boil again, so it won't be long, but I think I've kind of outlined what we're going to do. So in a few minutes, you'll see the gravy with the onions and mushrooms included, and it will be served with those pieces of pounded round steak. Our gravy is pretty much ready. I didn't add any more water, but as you can see, the consistency is looking good. And when we put the vegetables in, that's going to thicken it up, and it's time to put those in right now. And you can put as much as you want. Rick and I talked about it and thought we would like to have maybe half of this in the gravy and then the other half just in a side dish that you could dip more and put it on top of your serving of meat or leave it as is. If you put half of that mixture in, then your gravy is going to look like this, which looks wonderful. Actually, it's thickening up a little bit because I've left it on the stove. If you want it thinner, then just put more water in. You'll see it on the plate served in just a minute. I've plated up my pounded round steak, and you can see what it looks like. If you want to leave it just like that, that's fine. It's really good. It's very juicy and tender because of the pounding. Here are the leftover onions and mushrooms if you want to serve them to the side. And then my plan was from the beginning was to serve it with the gravy. So this is our completed gravy. I do want to taste of it and see if it's salty enough because I didn't add any additional salt, just the salt that came from the crust pieces that stuck to the skillet. I think I'm going to add a little bit. Actually, it could be used just like it is, but I think Rick and I both have a taste that would call for just a little more salt. So at this point, stir it around before you put it over your dish. And then if you have a large spoon, just spoon it over the top. But this is pretty much the look of our pounded round steak with onion mushroom gravy. And I hope you enjoy the recipe as much as Rick and I are going to enjoy eating this tonight. Here's our finished dish of pounded round steak with onion mushroom gravy. And I want to take a piece on my plate. So we'll just go right here. There's not a whole lot of gravy there. I'll take a little of the gravy from the top and just put that on. Try to clean up my plate a little bit. And then maybe I will take a little bit of extra flavor here as well. But what I mainly want to show you is what the inside of the steak looks like and to show you that it's very tender and I'll taste of it and I think it's going to be very tasty. So if you can see this, I'll turn it around where I'm going to make the cut. Let's see, it's pretty thick right here. So we'll go right where there's a lot of gravy. And that's what it looks like on the inside. And I'll just make this kind of small because it has gravy with the components of the gravy as well as meat. Here we go. Love round steak. It tastes great. If you never made it like this, and I doubt that you did because I just thought it up recently, you have to try it. It's really good.